I am not an organizer of the rally. I don't know where will be the official, allowed or forbidden areas. On this video you will see the states and the environment around the interesting places. Respect the rally organizers and marshals during the rally.
Welcome to the start line of special stage number 3 and 7 of Rally Finland 2024 Saarikas. It's a new name because it's totally new stage, which is really rare to see in Rally Finland anymore, so it will be interesting because of that. And for me it's also totally new. I know this big road really well because this is the one of the most driven gravel roads for me ever, but then it's always more part of this proper hard-paced gravel road before turning to smaller roads where I don't know a lot at all. But we will find out, and I did it like in purpose that I didn't want to check too much information, so I can really feel this now on the video like a new stage. It's 15.9 kilometers long, so that kind of medium length of stage, and already the second proper stage of the World Rally, so it makes this extra interesting. But for sure the biggest interest or moment of this stage comes because this is totally new. If you are new on these videos, I will be drive the stage, spot on every interesting corner, go to the side of the road, show you how would be the visibility from spectator point of view, and that is the basic thing. And for sure let's speculate everything interesting we can find, what comes to the road condition and whatever. Let's see, it should be here the start line. I guess there is this kind of junction that this is the spot, and let's just go. The weather is bad, you know, the meteo system said it will be full rain, which is good for filming, but it's full sunshine more than full rain, so I'm sorry about that, but I had the meteo info that I had and need to deal with it. Let's put the trip and go. I try to remember again to show you the trip so you know where we are going and where are the interesting spots. Need to also keep the Google Maps on, because as I said, I don't know the stage now.
Hey, nowhere before the map check. So first an overview, where is the stage located? Jyväskylä surrounded with green color on the down of the map, Lauka on the middle of the map, and Äänekoski on top of the map. Then Konnevesi, small village, big lake, right from the Äänekoski, and small but beautiful summer village, Sumiainen, on the really top of the map. The stage, it's colored with pink, so it's between Äänekoski, Konnevesi and Sumiainen triangle. Other modern Rally Finland stages that are close to this one are Äänekoski, below the Äänekoski city, Lankamaa, close to the Laukaa city, Laukaa, really close to the Laukaa city, and Myhimpää there on the right of the map. Then let's take a closer look to the roads that are used. So the start happens on Saarikkaantie, and from that we turn to Pukkitie, from Pukkitie to Soidinmäentie, and from Soidinmäentie hairpin left to Pitkämäentie, before turning to the final road, which is Tuomelantie. So the start and the finish of the stage are actually really, really close to each other.
But yeah, this big road is familiar for me. This would actually be already nice field corners, but there is no speed for this because the start line is so close, which is a bit shame, because I guess there would be a good room for the people. Most likely there will be some kind of spectating area, but is there nothing to see because they accelerate like 50 meters for that first left at least. Then we will have a little bit of dropping right to the dip, but I would say it's would be better on the other direction. I've been driving a lot of this on the other direction as well, and thinking that this would be that kind of spectator area for a big amount of people. These field corners now here, little bit dipping right and then a bit tighter left, but it's pretty short and it opens, so nothing special what comes to the corner. But let's stop and go to the field to check a little bit what would be the view on these corners. for sure a big question mark if you can be here because we are outside of the corner, but there is full of dirty water the ditch. But and the field as well. It was heavy raining the previous night, but you know, those must be put down if this is our official spectator area. That little green stuff and buses. So then you could see maybe somehow also the deepest part of the dip and then the next left. And for sure the angle of watching that downhill right is pretty nice. And then you could see the direction change. But little bit we are here on the low on the field, but for sure there's little uphill all the time. So if we go higher and higher, it should get better and better. And also when we go higher, we are more far away from the straight outside line of the corner. So the more most likely you are able to be here on this field. But I don't know. I mean, it's not really good. I don't really like it. And for sure there will be that field as well, but little bit similar situation. You cannot see nicely the wall through corners because these trees are then blocking fully this corner. There's actually a road to go. I don't need to jump over the ditch. Yeah. Not really good, but I guess he respected the area because this is the beginning of the stage, so basically easy to come. And this is like the only place that is even somehow interesting on this big road because it's so small part that we have this big road on this stage now. 0.5 arti kilometers. Somewhere here you could see something as well. Let's actually check. They have like cut it down a little bit. This field properly, but also there is that kind of sector of the field that has been cut it down. So is it already made for the rally? I don't know. But clearly you can see this sector here. Basically you can see 10 meters of that right, then the car will disappear and then comes again to visible, but it's already after the corner, so not good. And I guess it's totally similar situation for the other side of the road as well. But I hope there will be this kind of preparation already on this stage, because it's totally new and there hasn't been a lot of national rallies either. Some little rallies, yes, but I guess, okay, not really good visibility. But I guess that, you know, on those really small rallies, the organizers haven't put down the buses and pulled good spectator areas. So I hope there will be already something now for this big rally, because otherwise it's just all the time sitting here and guessing that are they going to put some buses down that will make a huge visibility or not, where they will build a spectator area, where not. All of that kind of things are new because the stage is new as well. Flat out, that is there really nothing to see. You can stop to that field, because already after this left we have one right and then the junction, if I remember right, away from this big road. Let's check. I mean, this has put it down as well, even if we are basically on the outside of the corner. Oh, better visibility than on the previous corners, but the corners are just way more boring. There's no need to, you know, break or lift the throttle. It's just, they can almost find a straight line through those two corners. So, as I said, I think nothing to see. Expect a really high speed, but is that worth of being a spectator? It's definitely not, in my opinion. Some kind of corner or jump or something you need, other than just driving straight flat out. Yeah. But again, this has been put down. Maybe for the rally, I don't know, maybe not. Could be even some night parking for the caravans or something. But then, the more interesting stuff should begin. It's not the most easiest braking maybe for the junction, because there's that, well, these flat out corners, there's really high speed when coming to the braking. And we have this kind of little crest, then the right, fast right, and immediately after that the junction is really looked like even maybe hidden. Let's check, I can't remember it 100% how it was. 1.2 are the kilometers for this. This kind of fast or even medium right. Somewhere here you need to start the braking and then flick the car to left here on this junction. Let's actually park the car here. But I don't know then if there are any good possibilities to spectate this junction. Really easy to come from that direction. Of course you need to drive a little loop if you go from Jyväskylä, but there's like, if these buses will be put down, maybe, but it's pretty tight the corner and you are outside of it, so I guess it's not a safe place to be from an organizer point of view, so maybe they are not building a spectator area there. There is no room to be, in case you are not allowed to be before those bigger trees here on the inside, but it's pretty narrow the sector again where you should be. And this must be put down, so it may be that this is not a junction for the spectators. There are other junctions as well on this stage, because there is many small roads connected together, so if you are interested on junctions, it's not the end of the world. Yeah, I mean, I need to be like 2 meters from the road to make some kind of visibility to the junction. If I go a little bit more back, it's starting to be blocked already, so this is not good. Not good at all for spectators. The road condition looks really nice on this big road. There's no loose gravel a lot. And really proper hardpacked road, but it's over now, unfortunately. And we go to the Pukkitie. And these are now new roads for me. I know there's chicane at the 9 kilometers. That kind of a junction kind of chicane. Need to remember that. And then few crash places I know from national rallies. One of them is actually pretty soon already. So I guess those one I can spot. Thirty kilometer per hour the limit. Need to respect that. Google Maps also died already. I would have liked to watch one Rekke video again before the stage, but the internet was even worse here than at the Ouninpohja, so at least with my operator. So if you are planning to be here all day, maybe you need to prepare that the internet is not really strong here. It's smaller road, but it's still pretty, you know, hard packed how it looks. There's not a lot of loose gravel or nothing like that.
and it's not small road. I would even say more like medium kind of road, which is pretty nice for the rallying in my opinion. First corner, short right. There's no way to be a spectator. We are on the yard area before entering to the fields, where there's actually two interesting corners then. This kind of downhill left. There is room for spectators, I can stop. This is not yet the interesting two corners that we have at the beginning of this road, but it's closest to the big road junction, so the most easiest to come to see this one. And I think the visibility is pretty nice. What comes to the length, you can see the braking and the how they put the car ready for the corner and how they drive the ball corner, and I guess, you know, there's good room for big amount of spectators, so everybody can see something. And basically you can even see maybe, there is maybe piece of road, I'm not sure. But that is the thing, it's pretty okay the view. Not super interesting corner, but it's still a corner, you need to brake and drive it, it's not flat out at all, so something to see at least, and the length of the visibility is nice. Little lake there as well, if it matters something. Then there is a wooden bridge, and after the bridge should be the first possible grass corner. Or at least corner that is even more, a lot more difficult than the previous ones. So really something to see there. This bridge costs nothing for the drivers, it's wide enough. No bumps or nothing like that at this point. But then we have this kind of tight left, there's nothing behind. And let's check. The radius keeps same, and then it tightens a little bit and narrows as well, and there is negative road camper, so there is now everything on this corner. 30 km speed limit also ends, so we can drive a little bit after this one, but let's check. There is still quite a lot of buses everywhere. And now, as I said at the beginning, at some point it's sitting here and guessing. Are these buses going to put down for the spectators or not? There is no chance for me at least to know, to get that kind of information, I think. And yeah, let's first go to the corner to see. And also, what's changed now, there is more loose gravel. The beginning of this road, the smaller road, it was okay. But now there is some amount of loose gravel, this kind of, I would say maybe medium, small kind of loose gravel. Not a lot, but a little bit. Will be a bit more slippy for the first cars than the really beginning of the stage. And yeah, on the inside there is a bit positive road camper, but clear negative road camper outside. So if you don't get the line, this negative road camper is your enemy here at the outside of the road. And there's a little bit of runout area. You know, straight after the road there is no ditch. There is hard ground, 1 meter still. And this will be possible maybe. But we are so close to the other people's yard, but it's a question mark. But it, oh, I don't know. You know, these are blocking a little bit. Even for the grass hunters, would this be a good place? You can almost see the wall corner, but then the, where most likely the crash will happen, if they run wide, it will be there. So it's a little bit blocked, but if they should run wide, then of course you can see from here as well. But then I think all possible, at least should be safe to spectate here on the junction. And see the action from backwards, in case it's possible. Some buses are taking away there, but wrong buses, what comes to the spectating on this corner, and this is not working either this direction because we are going a little bit downhill all the time, so no possible to see the whole corner here either. And as a corner, no matter where this kind of corner will be, it's interesting, but it's also a first proper difficult corner of the stage, which make this maybe even more extra interesting. I don't know if there's then the possibility that they are driving this more carefully because this is the first difficult corner, or could it be surprising because of that? I don't know, but at least something to think. First braking zone is not because there's the junction and the previous corner of the small road as well. We can go to the fields, but it's so bad now that there's no information about these. I mean, half of the buses are put down, but they have left a little piece. And then there's already information then on some point of the stage there will be a big spectator areas, and I guess these are the fields, not maybe this but then the next corner, but I mean maybe it's good, maybe not. How should I know through these buses? It's you need to get the information from somewhere else now, unfortunately. And for sure, if I get the information, I try to remember to comment on the video comments. I actually should already put something from the Ouninpohja comments as well, because there's the location of the chicanes has been published, so where I can go? There's deep ditch in that field. Maybe I just need to go. No idea what is here. Yeah, if those buses would be put down, you could see the apex and the exit of the corner. But then you are on the runout area, basically. I don't know then, if you just go further and further into this direction, where is the spot and the point where the rally organizer thinks that you are safe. How far away you should go, but good thing is that we are going uphill all the time, so the visibility basically goes better. The distance just gets longer and longer. There is already the next interesting corner, but it's actually best here. You can see almost the full corner. Let's not film the car, but almost the full corner. And I guess there's no way the car would go so far away, so maybe there's a spectator area. And my guess is that the big spectator area will start somewhere here and can continue to those next fields, because there's another interesting corner. Of course it's possible that the big area would be there on the opening fields of the stage, but those corners are so boring that it will be a big disappointment to put all the energy and effort for spectator area around that kind of corners. But let's see. Yeah, definitely better. Even if you need to be far away from the road, definitely better that the right side of the road than this left side if you are looking from the direction where the stage is going. And 2.5 are the kilometers for this. Then we continue. Accelerate a little bit. And we have a corner that has been working on national rallies. There's been actually many crashes. Not so many years ago. This kind of slight right, and it tightens then pretty suddenly after slight crest, and there's the ditch where the crashers has been going. So let's check the visibilities. I think I need to actually put my, let's park front of that thing, sunglasses away, because they're so hot that I can see nothing because of the fog on the glasses. That kind of corner, and it doesn't look as difficult as it has been in rallies, but for so many of the national rallies, crashes has been from the drivers who are driving without pace notes. So you cannot straightly say always that yeah this is good crash place from national rallies and like translate it to the WRC rallies. But for example, on this field, if you are interesting to see the possible moments and the crashes, the visibility is quite nice. You are not too far away from the road, and you can see the basically the apex and then the run out area. Bad thing is that this is a little bit downhill, so you need to get the front row to see something. Let's check the other field as well. And it may be affecting as well to the difficult level of this corner, that in case the big spectator area will come here, or even a smaller one, I'm pretty sure that some kind of spectator area there will be. That how it's located, how early the drivers can see it, and maybe guess from that there is interesting or tight corner. I guess it would be pretty nice, the field from top of this little crest. You can see to the previous corner, it would be like really amazing. And again, lot of buses. Are those going to be put down or not before the rally? I don't know. That's the reason why it would be better to film these videos as late as possible, but then I could not film all the stages, so need to do compromises. But especially if these buses would be patted down, it would be not only interesting corner, not only a possible crash corner, but only a place with a long visibility, so really really good place. And I would guess those are put down, but I just don't know. But yeah, the area where how the people are located here, then the spectators, it can give some kind of, you know, idea for the drivers, how tight the corner is, if the spectator area follows the radius of the corner. They can see it a lot better than without the spectators then. If they are driving without listening the bass notes. There is not a lot of positive road camper or nothing like that to help. Little bit yes. And the loose gravel situation, it keeps the same. I don't know then about the base of the road. It looks pretty solid still. It's just so dry now at the moment and sandy that it maybe that it looks a lot softer than it actually is. And this is the ditch then where many of the national rallies crashers went, or at least some of those. Depends a lot how much there has been rains, how deep it will be. But yeah, definitely the best corner so far on this stage. And I would say four people who are hunting grasses. Spectators that are interesting of grasses. This is the place to be of the world rally, I guess. Maybe there is some surprises then on the even smaller roads of this stage, closer to the finish, but it may be that this is the place to be. And I'm sure that many people are interested in about this corner, so you definitely need to be early. You know, also the second field, it's going a little bit downhill, so if you are not on the front row or the few front rows, you go down and down all the time and see nothing, so need to be really early here if you want to see. Then let's wake up the Google Maps. At some point there is a junction. And 2.8 the kilometers for this. And now we, unfortunately, we will get some reflections. But as I said, meteor system said full rain, so no can do. Here is then a junction and we go to the... Actually, I have no idea where we go. Right. I guess there is no need to stop for this one. Is there nothing interesting? Slight acceleration from the previous corner and lot of buses there on the inside, so nothing to see. Fast left and some kind of straight. The type of road keeps pretty much the same, I would say. The witness and it looks like the base of the road and the loose cross situation and everything, so no changes for that. Flat left or slight crest and then some bigger crest. Let's check how big it is. I don't know. I guess it's too slight. Slight crest to be a proper jump. There is a time to accelerate from the junction for sure to get the speed, but it's so slight the shape of the crest, but that I think it's not a big jump. And it would be really difficult to spectate because you need to go somewhere here. And then it's really blocked the view. So let's forget this one. But yeah, it's totally similar kind of road. There is just no way, I mean, so much stuff blocking to every direction and not good. Even the ditch is so wide that it's like pushing the spectators deep into the forest. Away from good visibility. But luckily it should not be a big jump. On the other direction it would be maybe a little bit bigger, bit dropping maybe, I don't know. 3.4 are the kilometers anyway for this crest.
some kind of a left. Narrows quite a lot. There is basically room for the spectators. And it's the only way to spectate this corner. You can see the, it was pretty short corner, so the apex and the exit, and then the flick to the next corner. If you are here, you will get gravel to your face for sure, but you can go to this direction for sure and maybe press a little bit green stuff down. But even if not pressing those down, it's okay, the visibility. You can see all the things that are possible to see from here. Nothing special, but okay, it's narrowing so much suddenly, the corner, and really high speed that they have when they are arriving this corner. There was like nothing, no braking points or proper corners after the junction. So this is then the first one. If there would be possibility to be closer to the road, I would almost call it like a adrenaline place. It's so short corner that they just, you know, break a little bit and maybe flick the car, trying to carry all the speed, of course, but it's a little bit killing the adrenaline place feeling that you need to be so far away from the road. 3.7 kilometers for that. Then it widens again, so it was those two corners, or basically only the one left that was narrow. Now this is almost as wide as the big road at the beginning, and again some kind of crest. Won't be a big jump, maybe little jump these are, but you know, there is Ruuhimäki on the loop of this Friday stages. If jumps are the thing that you are interested in, go Ruuhimäki for sure. Again, really long acceleration, and then little bit, you know, this actually reminds me a little bit one place of a Laukaa stage. Not anymore. 5 meter time it did it. Let's check. I wouldn't call it was hidden the corner, but there was little bit like a slight crest just before the corner. I don't know, like maybe 10 years ago, 10-15 years ago, when this would be down, this would be a lot more interesting. But now I think it's just the basic view you can get from the inside bank. There is so much stuff again that you just can't see the wall corner. There's no way. Semi-tight it is, but it's also really short, the tight part of the corner, and then it's really fast opens a lot. So it's not, definitely not so difficult than I thought when I first time saw it 1 minute ago, the beginning of the corner. It likes, already when it tightens, it opens. The tight part is like 10 meter, not even that. If you go here, there's no way you can see the exit of the corner, and if you want to see the exit, you cannot see the middle and the entry, so maybe you can go now there. But the result is this. No, it's just, even if you will put down those small buses, they are still these bigger trees. So it's just not,
not going to work for spectating point of view this corner at all. But yeah, when I said this reminds me a little bit of one place on the Laukaa, or I thought it will. We are pretty close to the Laukaa area stages anyway, Lankamaa and Laukaa. And when you think about this, it looks a little bit of those stages as well. There's something similar for Soran. I can remember when we first time, when the road was published and checked things from internet in our stream, we're talking about the same, that there's definitely something similar. Let's keep the sun went away for the whole day now. Now the lighting will be a lot better. Then it continues pretty fast, it seems. Some kind of really fast ride over a slight crest. It's now like a proper big road again, suddenly. Tiny crest again, then tightens a little bit to the left, but nothing special. I think it's pretty nice to drive fast. Slight crest and slight corners. But for spectator there's not a lot to see. You cannot even spectate the speed here because there's so much buses that there's no point. I mean, on every single corner I'm not stopping because I try to, you know, there should be at least one little point to stop, and those were totally pointless so far. Then it looks a little bit more tighter, but it should be short, looks like it. Yep, took the line and it's short again. Need to keep in that left for this right. Nothing, and it's just nothing, no way you can see something properly. Again, a slight crest, but not a big jump. Some left over crest, but again, only a little bit. But then, a lot tighter, looks like short corner. We have left, right, tighter left, and hey, tighter right. Let's stop. That was nice. 405 corner combination, like proper nice. I think you cannot spectate all of those, but at least this final one, 5.9 arti kilometers. How it was like left right, 4 corner combination. After really long flat out section, so not the easiest possible braking. This is the only option, I guess, to go there. I don't know. Would it be interesting or not? It's not easy braking, I guess. And maybe there's some possibility to run wide a little bit. The braking, and then make this ride difficult, but then this ride is not extremely tight, so will it really matter if they run a little bit too much to that side of the road, and then they can still do this corner. Let's actually check carefully that ditch, if there's some rocks. Little positive road camper here is, but nothing special. And there is, well, actually that bank is enough to cause some issues, I guess, in case they will run wide that braking. Camera was spotting really down. I fixed it now, but I hope it wasn't like that through the whole video. I'm sweating so much that it's moving on my head all the time. There is proper deep ditch and rocks, so if they run that one wide, it can really cause some issues for sure. One thing I wanted to check, how would be the view from that little open area there. Here you can see properly how they are entering this. So there was that slight left over crest, then the tiny right, then this tighter left and right. will it be anyhow reasonable to spectate here? Maybe. At least a little bit different kind of angle to watch. You can see a lot to that direction, but then you could see how they manage the braking and the direction change. I mean, why not? I mean, totally 50-50 for me if I would like to be here or there. Especially if it's damp or raining, the dust is not issue, so you can see from backwards as well the cars. And because it was 5.9 kilometers, the location for this one, we still have 10 kilometers to go, so one third of the stage done. And few good place to spot, so few good spot to spectate, I think was the thing I was trying to say. And looks that we have some kind of right, medium. Yep. And then it's like a junction. Junction kind of corner and maybe some possibility to spectate. Let's check. It's actually quite tight the end of the corner, but it's at the same time pretty wide. And there's no, sometimes when you have this kind of, you know, corner that enters to a right corner, the positive road camper of the right corner is a negative road camper of the left corner. But here it's not happening, unfortunately. It would have made this a lot more interesting, but there's no good road camper for that right. I guess this is bad place, because you're outside of this corner and then you cannot see that corner either, so pretty pointless to even go here, and every direction is blocked, but there was that kind of place that I will stop, because you could see the exit of this junction and then the next left. No idea what kind of left it is, but let's go and check. That one. And again, really big road. I thought these are smaller roads, but it may be that it's just the final road of the stage, and many people are talking about it, how soft and how narrow it is, but these other small roads are actually big roads, big or medium. Yep, from here you can see the fully the tightest part of the corner and the exit. But this left is nothing to see. But you need to get the really, or I don't know. Now we are already 10 meters from the road, and still it's somehow you can see the, now only the exit anymore, not the middle part or the apex, but I guess this is the place if you want to spectate that junction. It was so blocked the inside, and a bit dangerous place as well. Or maybe from backward, you know, from there could be possible, but is it then better? I don't know, but some possibilities there is to spectate that one. Is there even tarmac? A few slices of tarmac. And hey, new road again. Pretty. It's not so clay-based road than the road at the beginning or big road of Ouninpohja, for example. More this kind of lauka area, sand stages. But still we have ditches, because some places at the lauka area, especially on the Langamaa stage, there's no ditches at all, which is another speciality for the stages of that area, or at least for Langamaa. And 6.3 vertikilometers for that, and I forgot to show. Good acceleration again, we will have speed if there is something interesting where to use the speed. Short left, another crest, but again it looks pretty slight. And it is really slight. Bit more loose crawl now here. Not a lot still. It's flat right. Little bit tighter right now, but looks really short. Yeah, it opens. And soon we will have a junction, I can see it already from the map. So all the speed we will gain now, or they will gain, are used for the next junction. So it will be full braking from top speed. Is it now here? Yes. It's good junction area. I mean, now there is visibility possibilities a lot. This is nice. Nice for spectator. This kind of junction area. Reminds a little bit of Langamaa junctions again, because it's really, you know, lot of gravel, loose gravel, and looks pretty soft the inside of the junction. There will be big ruts, I think. There is no road camper or nothing available, so pretty slow place. And it's almost like a hairpin, or it is. You know, the direction says like 180 degrees almost. And really long. I mean, you can definitely hear the cars. They are coming from the rev limiter and then fully braking and doing this corner. So definitely going to see differences from the drivers. If there is anyone who can nail this braking with only one braking, but for so many drivers who are braking many times, not so good the visibility for that direction. Don't know again, most likely there will be some kind of spectator area here if the way put down a little bit the green stuff. Let's check from top of this. Doesn't help at all, but to this direction it helps a little bit. So and also here is good few rocks you can use to build up the visibility. Yeah, good junction area, definitely. It's also possible, maybe, that you will be able to be here on this side of the road. So little check. I don't know. Maybe a bit worse, and you can get something to your face. Then let's check the third option. And yeah, the sun is back again, so that's not good. I don't know. This is maybe the worst. Best, second, worst. But let's check us also from there and then another side of the road, how it will be to spectate the exit of the junction. Now it depends a lot. Where are the spectators going to be? If they are allowed to go really close to the apex, they will block your view. But if the stripe is like going from that, and then from the stripe to the apex is nothing, no spectators, then you could see okay from this place as well. And I guess there is no other options than the stripe would follow these trees. So it would be semi okay. It's quite blocked at the apex, especially when there's people. So not so good. But many options and it means that you don't have to be the first one here. You can still see something from some point around the junction. I don't know, most likely it will be so soft that it could be semi-interesting place for the next or the second loop as well. There will be so big ruts. See how the car struggle to accelerate from the ruts. Then it looks it's going to be more sandy and soft the road now. And maybe not so wide anymore. Let's check. And wakey the phone again. The kilometers for this one. And if I remember right, I said 6.3 for the previous. So it's like more than 1 kilometer flat out acceleration before this braking, so it's a proper braking zone. And 1.5 kilometers there is before the chicane. It should be around the 9 kilometer. Yeah. It's more sandy now. More and more langama feelings. It's really flat corners. The visibility would be okay because it's not so full of buses anymore, the forest, but so far nothing to see. Expect maybe here. Let's check from the bank. There was a little bit like a direction change on top of the crest, so would that be a flat out place? Somehow just need to find a spot where to pull the visibility. It's at least close to happen. It may be this little crest if it's going to... Those must be put down, otherwise no. It will be semi-long the visibility and you will see that flat direction says and flat this one as well. But again, the green stuff is this kind of 5 meter trees are destroying the thing that I thought would be nice to see really flat out corners. Same here. It looked a lot more open, the forest, from the car than it actually is now. But look at these langama vibes. And more sand based. The wall road and in places even no ditches, more like a bank, so definitely looks like Alankama. But if it's this fast and wide this wall road, it's not so big problem for the first cars, because the need for grip is not so high than on the technical roads. And that side of the road, you know, the next left, it's even more fulled with green stuff, so let's cancel these flat out corners. 8.2 kilometers for these. For this one, they have put a new layer of little flag on the Laajavuori stage. What should that help? I don't know then, but new layer of gravel. Let's check if there's some ways to spectate this. At least there is option to go there, but again, many smaller trees to block the view. But yeah, it's this kind of a, how to call it, it's not basically a chicane, but slow down double junction, I don't know. Let's not film the bicycle. But I think you could be, maybe here should be not dangerous or anything. And you can see somehow through the trees, but for sure it's semi-blocked the view. Then how they flick to the chicane or the slowdown area. And it's really, I mean, yes, there is the new layer, but below that, this is like, I don't know what. Snow. As soft as snow. Then, how about somewhere here? I don't know what are these. Not for the rally for sure. These are older than this year stuff. Better in my opinion. If there is people, they are blocking your view, but then you can see how they enter to this slowdown area. Even better, basically, even though those are a little bit blocking, but goes better and better. Even better. This could be the place to be if this is just allowed, but why not? At least should be not dangerous. There's even good flat spot. Not so good the visibility anymore, but somehow you can see the wall area basically. It's not the most stupidest slowdown area that I have seen. A lot better than those hay bales she came, for example. And again, especially on the second run, there will be deep ruts, so there's like a little bit more to see when the cars are struggling on those ruts. But look at the how soft is the base of the road here. It's like nothing. And I guess this kind of new layer can't help a lot, but we will see then. I don't know if there will be any point to be somewhere here. Because I think the most interesting part is the entering to this area. This is already so slow, they don't have speed for this corner, so it's just going slowly through. But entering to this one, it's a lot more interesting. I don't know if we can say it's tricky one, but after really long flat out section, a really hidden junction. But for sure, if you run wide the braking, nothing bad happens, you just lost time. But then if someone brakes a little bit too late and tries still to make the corner, then there will be something nice action to see. There is that one that can cause some bad things. But okay, there's another one as well. So it will punish if they will run to this bank, most likely. If they manage to hit to that spot, maybe not, but that is bad, and that one as well. Maybe that is moved then on the rally, but I think it's not my job to change the landscape or anything on these roads. And now, if I remember right, will be the second crash place of this stage that I know from national rallies. But this slowdown area is making a little bit harm for that place now. Otherwise they would have been driving few kilometers flat out before the surprising tight ride. But now let's think a little bit. They will do these corners. And how much then there is time to accelerate. For sure, powerful rally car will gain the speed really fast, but you know, the rhythm and the flow is killed. Okay, there is good amount of straight still. Maybe that is not affecting so much than I thought for the next interesting place. It's flat. The next slight left as well. There is maybe basically room for spectators, but nothing to see. It's so slight the corner that it's just not corner at all. I don't know where to go. I think we go here to the left. Yeah, I can't remember that kind of junction at all. The phone is dead again. Is it then now the surprising ride? No, or is it? No, yes, no, yes, yes it is. It is pretty surprising, which is good thing. Nice little parking area as well. Let's check. And one key thing is that there's nice area for the spectators. There's now no green stuff blocking the view or nothing. They will be good and safe here on the inside bank. And you know, now nice this kind of soft ground to be. Even you know, if you are a camper, maybe you can come and sleep here. This is good kind of forest for those kind of activities. But yeah, the whole corner you cannot see. That's for so clear. But somewhere here you can see the tightest part and the possible white line. And there was even roll, if I remember right. You know, some national cars run it wide to that bank and roll it then. And so really like wide slides, big moments that they managed to save. Few blueberries as well. And yeah, if you go here, you cannot see the exit so well anymore. But couple of people at least can see the best part of this corner quite nicely from top of this bank. I don't know exactly, I'm not so familiar with this place, that how long walk it will be to this spot. But I guess it won't be the most popular one. Some amount of walking you need to do for this one, so it helps to get the good spot if you are ready to do the walking. Otherwise, I don't know if there's anything special on this corner. It's just even quite a lot of road camper, actually. Especially on the inside line, but no rocks or nothing. It's just really surprising. It's, you know, really long the flat section, and long time it looks that okay, this is pretty slight corner as well. It little bit goes to the right and right all the time, but then suddenly it tightens quite a lot. So now on this kind of rally, which is not a blind rally, which means that they are not driving without the pace notes. I don't know if this could be even more surprising than the field corners at the beginning. This is a little bit like if you had the rhythm on and you cannot stop it, this can be surprising, but there's no rhythm for the beginning corners at all. Those are just tight corners at the field. It may be that there's more surprising potential on this kind of corner. 10.2 or 10.1 kilometers for this one. Okay, road goes more narrow and again turning quite a lot, so maybe we will get some kind of nature to the road now. And again turning, so definitely that long flat section is over. There's some kind of junction, but I don't know if it's going anywhere that you could use that when arriving this stage. Some kind of left, and it's turning again some amount, so definitely more nature on this road now. And hey, this one I know, really long open area. There is these two semi-fast corners at the beginning. Good thing is that you can see maybe quite well on these spots, but bad thing is that there's nothing to see. Expect a really high speed. On the really end of this open area there's something, but it's also the end of the open area, so it may be that the open area is not helping you anymore there, but we will see it soon. At least it looks there's no man putted those, you know, baby trees, which many times are the reason why the spectators are not allowed to be on this open area, so that looks good. You can see those really fast corners here if you are interested with good visibility. It's not a bad angle to look, you know, a little bit downhill that left there, but is there then nothing to see? I think no. But at least easy to watch from here. Then I think let's stop on the middle of this open area, then on the end. In case there's nothing special. There's tiny crest, but if I'm right, it's not a jump. Otherwise people will have been talking about it a lot more than they have been. so far. 10.9 are kilometers for this one. I wake up the map as well. Really long and slight crest, so nothing to see. And actually we didn't have to stop on the middle of the open area because it was already that tiny crest. But let's check from top of that bank. There was some kind of ride over crest, and then we go back into the woods, and there's tighter left if I'm right now. Let's stop the car here. Yep. So it may be that this kind of place, if it's damp or raining, which means that there's no dust, could be okay to watch from behind the braking over this crest, how they take the line from the right and then flick the car to the left. At least the visibility is really long. Long and nice. You can almost see the downhill left. That is the entry to this open area, and you actually see there was white car on the park, and I can see it. So really long the view, and for sure from top of that crest there is nothing disturbing the view. Then the braking and flick to that corner. So this is okay, and I guess even if it will be dry and dusty, you can still somehow see the entry of that corner as well. And it looks like there's so much buses on the inside of that left, that this is the best option to spectate that corner, even if you would not be interested in about that flat out. But that corner, maybe there on the outside as well. Let's check that one. But before that, let's check this side of the road. It's not so good. The more you go to the left, the less you see that corner, so that side is a lot better. I never ever struggled so much to keep this camera on my head than on this video. And it's annoying if I go, or when I go back to the home and I see that half of the video is looking on the sky or to my feet. Again, there's quite a lot these kind of corners that there's like 1 kilometer flat out and then something more tight. It has been like the rhythm and the flow in many places on this stage. Which basically means that there is a rhythm and the nature, even if it's not that kind of constantly flowing and dancing than it could be. And what is maybe the most stereotypical example of a rhythmical road. It's not actually not bad looking at all. It's a little bit question mark if you are allowed to be here. I would say it looks safe, but again, my opinions are sometimes different than the rally organizer opinions. You could see the cars braking over the crest and go there. And what's more, you could see this wall corner, even the flick to the next corner. So more interesting than being there, but for sure it's more likely that you are allowed to be there, and the visibility in total is longer if you are top of that bank. How about should I? This has been a little bit like a tradition that I try all these possibilities as well. Hey! I look at that direction and I was like, okay, this is nice. But then that direction, not so nice. Those are blocking quite a lot. But it's so good on that direction that this is actually a good option. And I'm pretty sure that there is no way that car can go, you know, over you if you are standing on this. It would mean it would go over all these, through all those trees and then climb over this rock, so I would say it's a safe place to be in case you are not falling down. Okay. definitely okay spot. And I guess there's no need to even be or go to the inside of that. It's full of buses. But then from there could be some possibility to see the exit of this one and the next corner. So let's check that one. 11.3 are the kilometers for this. Some kind of a bridge. Nothing special. And then how about from the outside of this corner entry? Good room for the spectators who are spending their whole day on one stage. Just park the car there and put the camp. I don't know, you will get the gravel to your face and it doesn't look good at all, the previous corner either from that point of view. So definitely that direction is better. Hey, 4 kilometers to go anymore. There has been more interesting corner than I thought. I thought these are not so interesting, the small roads, than they actually are. Again, is it that we accelerate a little bit, get the proper top speed, and then break into some slow corner. This one is not that corner yet. It's pretty short, you can make it pretty fast with a proper line. Really short right. Looks similar, maybe a bit sharper. Left. Yep. A little bit more narrow the road and it's not so sandy now. There's amount of loose coral, the base of the road is more clay based, at least on this spot. We call this sulle mulle corners in Finland. That's kind of just left right, basically nothing. You just do those. Flat, 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 every corner. Maybe here and there you need to break a little bit, but nothing to see. But basically it means that again the next tighter corner can be a little bit surprising. Is it this one then? It is. There is a few these kind of corners. Okay, there is no need to stop. Look at the inside. There is no way you can spectate this corner. But yeah, at the end of the stage, I know there is a few these kind of places where it's like a little bit open background and tight left. Two or three, and this was the first of them, but you cannot spectate. Definitely no chance to be there. It's a little bit bad that it's uphill the corner, it makes it less difficult, but it matters nothing because you can't be there. 12.5 are the kilometers, but at least at the moment so much of buses that no chance. Most likely a forbidden place to be a spectator. But nothing to see in case this final left is not. No, it's not tight. Yep. There there's some kind of, this may be the best, you know, what comes to the nature of the road, this road that we are now driving. It has a rhythm. It's really fast, but you know, it's a little bit short corner all the time here and there. Not that kind of straight all the time. And hey, if I'm right, there's junction left now. And how much does it reminds this place the one of the earliest junctions of Ruuhimäki? Unfortunately, there are some people now coming to that direction with the dogs, so I guess I need to wait a little bit, but then I just wait a little bit. But you know, the for example, 2015 shakedown, the first junction of 2015 shakedown on Ruuhimäki. There's a little bit higher bank. Okay, 5 minute break playing with the dogs done. But I think I was saying that this reminds a lot of Ruuhimäki junction. How is the forest there on outside and little bit bank we are missing from the outside of the entry of the junction, but otherwise similar kind looking junction. Quite a lot of buses and green stuff again. If there will be a spectator area, this will be put down a little bit again, I guess, but at the moment it's just so difficult to show the view, because we don't know how much they are making this better, or are they making this better at all. But yeah, then there will be the spin corner of Andreas Mikkelsen, and is it the crash corner of Erik Pietarin on the Ruuhimäki? This is so similar looking place. That is, I guess, for sure forbidden area then. And on the Ruuhimäki there will be the bank where the spectators are, or has been, already been. And again, so much green stuff that I don't know. Impossible to say. Nothing special as a junction area. There was a lot better the hairpin when entering the big wide sandy road, for sure. Little bit of downhill braking. Quite narrow the junction, so not the most easiest one either. And quite a lot of that kind of small rocks, but then these two can be bigger one when they, you know, come alive when there is big ruts, then otherwise it looks pretty clean. But look at it's pretty narrow actually the road, because already here it started this kind of ditch and it's really soft, so it can be it's not on the great shape and condition, especially then on the second loop, and especially if people keep on, you know, running wide this corner, this exit outside of the corner can be really messy. And this is not really narrow. That local people said as well, it's not so good that there is a lot of traffic now. So narrow the road that they cannot really use the, or they can use only one direction. There is so much traffic going all the time. And this is now then the smaller narrow road that people are talking about. Not all the previous small roads. And there should be one crash place, one really big rock that I know already. And otherwise I don't know so much about this one. 13.3 the kilometers for the previous junction, I forgot to say again. Okay. First corner was nothing, that kind of short medium right to the uphill. And now there's already some open area in front of me, so is this one now the one old grass corner? If the road goes left, it can be. I don't know if that is confusing or not, maybe not. It's so, you know, narrow then. It doesn't look like a road, but tight is the corner. Really tight. Let's check. 13.6 kilometers for this one. And I guess you can be here pretty alone if you come here, so can we leave it that kind of like own corner or someone? You can see the braking, but then the late entry, apex and exit pretty nicely. So it's okay. Okay, small road corner. Really good road camper, unfortunately, to help the drivers and prevent some nice slide action, but there's good speed for this corner, or at least medium kind of speed. Little bit of crest, little bit of confusion, but I don't know if it's enough. I guess no, but something, you know, that maybe make this more difficult than just the tightness of the corner. I'm pretty soft looking the inside as well, so will be some rut. So okay corner, definitely okay corner. And that kind of corner I would maybe, you know, if you're spectating national rally classes, the Vetomies, this would be nice for those. Or at least I don't like to watch those on really fast places. They look nothing after the Rally 1 and Rally 2 cars. Or top of them look, but then there's a lot of slower cars as well, where I would like to prefer the slow corners. And yep, it is narrow and soft. There is even a little bit green on the middle of the road, which tells that the traffic is not that massive on this road. Got the basic 10 meter visibility there if you want, but the corner itself, it wasn't so interesting that it could be. Slight corners, little bit same kind of rhythm on this road at the moment than there was on the previous road where I was talking about, but then again more tight. There's no way to spectate, it was so much full of buses. But actually, what about those area? Or those rocks on that area? There was a little bit of sumppu. Sumppu, I mean that one there, for the previous corner, but it's so close to the road that you cannot stand on top of that rock. And then if you go to the forest, you see nothing. But from here you will see it. You will see it somehow. Maybe, but no. Well, somehow, yes. You can see the sumppu and then. But not a great spectating spot. But I needed to stop, it was an open area, so needed to check. Here you can see a little bit the road, so really sand-based road. Looks like there's no clay base at all. The loose gravel situation is actually not terrible. Sometimes it's terrible on these roads, but then on the other hand, when it feels that the whole road is just, you know, hard-packed loose gravel, it can be that it's not really nice for the first cars. But at least there's no fresh layer of loose gravel on top of this. Anyway, soft road. Kilometers at the moment where we are going, so still few kilometers to go. Or how long it even was, I can't remember. Was it 15.9? Maybe it was. So we still have time to find something good. A medium right. Some kind of a crest system. To the left. Hey, this is the old crash corner, if I'm right. I need to double check it from home. And when I'm putting the timestamps and everything on the video, I try to remember to write it down. But I guess this is it. Because, you know, I don't know if it's now good to tell the story if I'm wrong, but I take the risk. You know, when these were more down, it was confusing a lot. You know, over the crest. What I was thinking as well, I say that there's normally little crest thing, little bit to the left, but actually it's a lot and it's really, really narrow. So if you lost the rear of the car on the braking, how are you able to do the next corner? No way. So really interesting place. And a lot better than the previous single tight right. Sorry, left. And good rocks to choose. Hey, this can be my place to be. In case I'm doing only 3 stages on Friday, this on the first loop. Just watch all the cars here, and then Lauka Ruuhimäki on the afternoon. It's even long the visibility if you got this rock. And I'm ready to run for this. Really nice corners. It's not, you know, fast place at all, but it's that kind of nice, slow, small road place in the middle of nowhere. If you can just make the rally radio work here, you have everything you need for a nice rally morning at Friday. The more you go this direction, then the less you see that direction, and basically all the straight is missing, but these are so interesting corners that it's not a big shame if you don't see the braking and coming to this corner, if you can just see these corners. I mean, look at the width here. There you can't go with the car, and then not here either, so it's really narrow, the road. And I guess this side of the road will be the spectating area. Here you can get again gravel to your face, so the hotspot of this spot is actually pretty small, I would say. And I guess then these are forbidden, because we are on the outside of the left corner. Would be really nice for sure, but you know, not going to happen in Rally Finland. Or no, at least I'm surprised if you are allowed to be on those corners. No, there's so, you know, these are starting to block your view if you go to that direction, so it's pretty simple where you need to be on this spot, and for sure you need to be early here as well. But lot of rocks here if you run wide. Something will, you know, get broken for sure. I don't know what are those, you know. Or they already put it down. There will be some kind of spectator area. There's no other reason that only these, you know, trees would have been put down. I was wondering that I can't remember that there would have been any other spot where this would have happened already. Which is a bit weird. But it could be also marked that this is an official spectating spot. Which means you need to be really, really early here, because the more official, the more people there will be. And also, you know, that these are put down on this side of the road, which is a bit surprising. Like, they're like started to make this confusing, but then quitted the job. They wanted to do a little maisemointi, but they cancelled their plans. Could it be option to be somewhere here, then I don't know. Well, it's not really bad, basically. But a little bit, you know. If this bus could go down, it would be a lot better to be top of these rocks. There is quite the money. If you are not getting the rock, then no good, but there is rock for 10 people at least on this side as well. this is really nice. Especially if there will be possibility on the Saturday to get 2+2. Two stages on the morning and two stages on the afternoon. There will be no question that I will take only 3 on the Friday and come to this place, but if I go to this place, then it means I get only 3 stages on the Friday as well, which means the total amount of stages will be pretty little during the whole rally, which is bad. But on the other hand, when next time you will get the totally new stage with this kind of nice corner, where is definitely some kind of action potential from direction. I purpose was to go backwards. So maybe you need to sacrifice the amount of stages to enjoy this kind of situation that this new stage seems to give you. I mean, there's been many good places, not only this one. Then there's that one. Let's check. I just don't know where to park the car. It's so narrow the road that if I do it here, I will block the road, but maybe it's okay. So far the traffic has been really small. Unfortunately, you cannot see fully the previous corners. If you would see those from top of this rock, this would be awesome, but it's not. But there's these kind of things. Mosquitoes going into mouth. There's even trees, big trees on top of this. Yeah, unfortunately you cannot see the previous corners. But you can be like top of the rally car. I'm pretty sure it's forbidden to spectate the rally here, because you will be on top of the car. And it's so flat you would even put the camp here, but must be forbidden. I mean, must be. And actually, the angle will be really unique, but otherwise, what is the thing you see? Straight piece of road, so it's not worth being a spectator on top of this. Then I don't know anymore. As I said, there was two or three surprising left, and I think that was the final one that I remembered somewhere, which means, is there anything left on this road anymore? That kind of really interesting that people would be already talking about all the time. I don't know, 14.7 arctic kilometers now, so it was like 14.6, 14.5 for the previous corners. I guess I forget to say it there. Another big rock, but again nothing to see on top of it. Hey! Again semi-tight and long corner, but you can see nothing from there. You have the basic 10 meter of visibility. I can maybe stop now, because it's so easy to stop. Normally I'm not stopping at this kind of corners, but you could see the possible white line and grass if you are allowed to be, for example, here, but quite close to the road you are. And still it's blocked, so. And this is the best, the only open area of this wall corner, so. That is what I mean, the basic 10 meter visibility. And then I can already see there is really tight right into the fields, but unfortunately this downhill left is killing the speed. If this would be more fast corner, that kind of long left, and then suddenly tight right, it would be pretty likely that someone would exit to the field, but they need to drive the left so slow that I guess they don't have speed for this corner. And then we can already see that the type of the forest, not forest, the environment is changing a little bit because we are away from the forest to the fields now. Yeah, there's really good road camper as well, so should not cause any issues this corner. I guess you can be pretty close to the road, yes, but is it worth of it? I would say no. Because of the slow entry speed of this corner. Otherwise it would be, you know, somehow okay maybe. Then let's check if we go to the forest anymore at all. If I remember right, at least the finish of this stage was on the fields. It's now 14.9, so 1 kilometer to go. So most likely the forest is done. Straight piece of road. Tiny crests, but no big jumps. There is maybe one corner now then. Again, where we gain a good amount of speed. And then need to do the braking and systems. One more possibility, one or two, I guess. For spectator area. Short right, left, right. Quite funny piece of road. Let's go actually. Nice park. But now it depends a lot if there will be a cutting blocks or not. Because if there's no cutting blocks and they can cut these corners, it's almost straight piece of road. I mean there's nothing on the ditch. They can almost find a straight line. That wire is a little bit disturbing. But otherwise, this could be driven really fast speed. But if there is cutting block, and there as well, on top of that wire, then it's a lot more technical place. So it depends a lot of that, what will happen. And the official Recce videos are out already. So, for example, from those we cannot see the cutting blocks. So it's only the information you can get if you come to see these on the final week of the rally. Or you have some friend who is driving these through and telling you the information. Little bit difficulties can be to spectate because that piece of forest is blocking everything on this field. That field is little bit, or quite a lot actually, like a run-out area. Maybe on the end of this field is the only option. And now as we are really close to the finish of the stage. Well, here you can see it somehow. But I don't know. It was more fun, that kind of piece of corners to drive, and will be more fun to drive, I guess, than spectate. And yeah, you know, those buses are blocking. But anyway, this is so close to the finish of the stage, that maybe there is some kind of spectating area. And also now I understand that we are so close to the finish of the stage that it's pretty easy to go to there. Okay, there was the landowner of the house and he told some nice information. These buses will go down, those buses as well. And this will be official spectator area. There will be night park for the people. Just where the forest stop on that field, I'm not sure. And there will be a proper, you know, hail bale blocks for this wire to protect it. So now we know a little bit more about this one. And then the official spectator area will end, you know, where the forest end as well. So it could be that the tricky corner there is not official area at all, which is basically good. Maybe there's not so million people then. And he also was the guy who has put the buses down from that spot already. And he said that, you know, now the job starts. So basically, I was a bit too early now here, but you know, I wanted to be early more than, you know, too late. It's always still better like this. But then he wasn't sure if on this corner will be cutting block or not. We will see that then. But that is protected. And it can make this one pretty tight, you know. Depends now a lot if there will be cutting block or not. And yeah, those buses as well will be go down. Oh, I don't know then. We will see soon what kind of visibility possibilities there are more to that direction. But those will go down. That will go down and that will go down as well. So the way you can see these corners will be then a lot better. And generally he said a lot, you know, that many buses are going to go down on this wall stage area, so it sounded good. Are the kilometers for this one, so it's now 400 meters to the finish anymore. I can't remember the kilometers of the tricky corner, the narrow left right. So how long is the walk, but it's not long, you know. It's pretty good. You don't need to walk like 1 hour, but still you need to walk some amount, so all of the people are not going to be, I don't know. Let's not stop that anymore. This kind of right and left. Don't know about these buses, if these are going to down as well, but it's downhill the for wall of yield, so it would be difficult to see these corners anyway. A little bit of downhill, but it's not giving anything more. I think it's pretty much it. And yeah, somewhere here will be, you know, then closer to the big road. We are basically really close to the start of the stage now. Somewhere here is the finish line. 15.9 are now done, so it doesn't really matter if it's here or 200 meters that direction. But yeah, he said that there will be parking area somewhere here close to the big road, and then they will make a pathway, bridges over the ditches and everything. Good pathway for the people to go to the final corners, and if they then want to continue to the difficult corners, they can do that one as well. So it's done now. New stage. Really rare to have a new stage, as I said at the beginning, so really nice to have this kind of system now in Rally Finland for the drivers, of course, but at least, you know, for the spectators. I don't know, it's just more nice for the spectators or drivers, but I think both are enjoying to have new roads, and it was a lot better than I thought. The first big road, it gives nothing. Even the junction to the smaller road is impossible to spectate. But then at the beginning of the smaller road, there was three basically corners. There was that downhill left with good visibility, not the crash corner. After that, the tight tightening left, long tightening left. little bit difficult to guess how is the visibility because there was a lot of buses. And then after that one, the old crash corner, where was the ditch on the outside that, you know, tightening right over crest on the fields. And at least that one guy said now that now it starts the job. They start to put the buses down on this stage, so most likely those will be down. After that, I cannot remember a lot. There was one, some kind of, you know, left-right combination to the downhill where the final right was the tightest. And then it was quite a lot of, you know, flowing roads. There one slow down area on the big Langamaa kind of road. Then the one really big open area, semi-nice corner after it. And then for sure that final really tight and narrow left-right. Those I can remember now. Most likely those are the hotspots of this stage. So at least few really nice, at least five okay kind of places to be. So that's semi okay. It's okay stage. For sure not my favorite, but it's okay. Definitely okay stage. And interesting to see then the condition of this final road. How rutted, how soft it will be. It's question mark still. But nothing more to say. See you on next videos and Rally Finland.